I'm just going to say, this is Coralie Condon, sitting in the comfort of her own home with some nice people around me, about to talk about early days, or my early days, in television. Well, I had just left the Commonwealth Government, and I was thinking of going to Sydney, and was walking along St. George's Terrace when I ran into Brian Treasure, an old friend of mine, and he said to me, what are you doing? And I said, well, I'm going off to Sydney to try my luck in television. He said, I want to talk to you about that. And I said, go on. And he said, we've got a committee formed, which is the first committee of TVW Channel 7. And I said, what's that? Didn't even read the local papers at the time. Anyhow, he said, why don't you come along and see us and see what you can do for television here. And I said, well, I'm like anyone else in Perth, I know nothing about it. And he said, never mind, come along. So I said, right, he made me a date. So on that date, I went down to Newspaper House, old newspaper house, and saw Jim Crothers, Frank Moss, Bill McKenzie, whom I consistently called Phil McKenzie, and Brian Treasure and a few others I didn't know. And so they talked to me about starting television going. And I said, well, personally, I want to know what I'll be doing in it. Oh, well, you'll be there doing whatever. And I said, what is whatever? And they said, well, what would there be, says one to the other. You'll do anything, and you'll do this, that, and the other. And I said, for what money? Oh, we haven't got down to that yet. I said, listen, I'm a lady without a job. What money? They said, we'll think about that. I said, well, it seems to me you want a dog's body. And they said, well, it's a very, you know, rough term to put on what we want, but we do need a woman in the business and you're the woman. And I said, that's very charming. I might add, on the second interview that I did have, which was, I think after, well after that, or a long time after that, I was still going to be a dog's body, and I can say, till the day I died, I was still a dog's body. What's a dog's body do? Go around and think, that chair can be on the road, so move it, and things like that. You know, just an interest in television.
So, Koo, what was the actual date you started in television?
I started on the end of July, I can't remember what date, but somewhere towards the end of July 1959. And that's the sound of Audrey Barnaby at the time, because when I did take the thing on, and a passing traveller called in, and she happened to be a woman who was absolutely up to the last moment in television makeup. And she came to me and she said, they know nothing about it here. And I said, of course they don't. I don't know anything about it. What do you think they're going to do? Give them Max Factor 5 or something like that and get going. Anyhow, we eventually realised that if you're having a television station, you've got to have someone to put makeup on people, because people like to feel they're looking at their best. So I knew Audrey because she and her husband lived in the same block of flats as me. I went down to Foy and Gibson's, where she was in charge of Coty and Helena Rubinstein and so on. And I said to her, first of all, I didn't say what I wanted her for, but we ran into another worker there who wanted to get into television. So I said, we'll do auditions on such and such a day if you come out. So they were coming out on this certain day.
And well, I hadn't gone out for the audition, had I?
No. I was about to say, the other woman asked Audrey would she go along for company. So she went along for company. By this time, I had done the initial auditions, and I auditioned 365 people in 3 days, I think, but we did it. I was used to doing it in the theatre, and you know, you got the feel of it all. Anyhow, when Audrey came out, I auditioned her friend, and then I said, the commissioner to get Audrey, and she came in, and I said to her, I'm going to audition you. She said, I didn't come out for an audition. I said, you try it. What'll I do, she said. And I said, interview me. And she didn't know a great deal about me, but she knew something. And so she asked me questions, and that was that. So Audrey got the job that her friend came for. And that was the beginning of television, part of the beginning of television.